There's a lot of reasons that deer can have deformed antlers. One of them is injury to the antler itself. If a deer injures an antler while it's growing, you will see some type of deformity on the antler through the rest of that year. Now, if the antler is mostly done growing, maybe it just injures the tips, then you start seeing some of those acorn points or some of the little blunt tips at the end. That's very minor, but it's clearly a result of that deer hitting that on something else. More significant injuries, maybe to the body of an individual, can cause larger injuries to the antlers to the point where the entire antler on one side or both sides can be deformed. And in general, if a deer is injured in the back of its body, the antler on the opposite side is the one that's deformed. If a deer is injured in the front of the body, the antler on that same side, the opposite side, or both sides can be deformed. So also, we can have an injury to the skull itself or the very base of the antler, which causes all kinds of crazy deformations that then are carried through the life of the deer. So a little bit of sleuthing to kind of figure out what is going on. If a deer has an injury to the body that causes an antler deformity, in many cases, it will carry that for the rest of its life. Not always, but for the majority of the cases. If the injury is to the growing antler itself above the burr, that typically is only that year. The next year when it gets a new antler, there is no sign of that injury from the year before. However, if the injury is very low on the antler, like right at the base of the pedicle, that is something that will get carried through the rest of that deer's life because it has messed up the growing portion of where that antler starts from. And the final way we see some from deformities is through brain abscess. This is actually a bacteria that can get on a deer's forehead. They can get this when they're fighting, when they're rubbing. It's something that they pick up in the environment, but it can actually make it through the skin to the skull, and then will literally eat through the bone and cause an abscess around the base of the antlers that can cause all kinds of crazy deformities. Now, what's amazing with this is the strength of white-tailed deer. Deer have been seen literally chasing does during the fall. Deer get shot, go up to the buck, and literally have the antler almost ready to fall off because the bone all the way around the skull has literally been eaten through by this bacteria. So the fact that the deer could even run around or try to partake in the rut is just absolutely amazing. Now, there's a lot of research going on about these brain abscesses to figure out exactly what is happening here, because there are only a couple places in the country where they are really relevant, such as the Eastern Shore of Maryland, Georgia, are two places where we see high rates of this. Other parts of like Texas, where you have a lot of older bucks, this is almost non-existent. So we still have a lot to learn about these deformities relative to the brain abscess, but cranial brain abscesses are definitely more common today than in the past, largely as a result of just more older bucks that are out there. So this is just one more way that you might see some type of deformities. And then obviously from a brain abscess, if it does have a deformity, that is something that buck will carry for the rest of his life.